The internet is a great place for moviegoers to share their opinions across the globe. Fans of pop culture love to discuss and detract in the harrowing comment section, and mostly love to theorize and get into the funky brain of their own and open up doors and doors of deeper meanings that would make Albert Einstein scratch his head. Anyway, I'm here to add to the brain headaches, as I have a lot of things that I believe are canon, confirmed, and legit to every source, because I'm better than those money-grabbing employees at Film HQ. Anyway, as before, I'm Darren Edwards, and this is my new segment, Teapot Theory, and here are top 10 film theories I have. Number 1. Carlisle and Indiana Jones are in a shared universe. They both have a gut extreme passion for adventure. Ever notice how in the other world, Carlisle goes in to face down her doom or her destiny, and Indy does the same when he's in a situation. Similar shots in both films include parental issues with their unique passion for quests. In my view, they really painted a picture in plain sight that these two Joneses are related. They both have a really big pinpoint for adventure, and Miss Jones even wears a hat near the third act of the film. There is no doubt that Tommy Wommy living with his mummy will comment and say one is stop motion and the other is live action. My answer is that The Clone Wars was animated and Caroline is based on a book. So if they ever made a film adaptation in live action, there is no doubt that Harrison Ford would make some sort of cameo appearance. Let's make it happen, guys! Number 2. The DWCU is real. Ever since those hack frauds at Comcast ran DreamWorks into the ground, we haven't gotten many sequels to our beloved treasures of cinema and our heroes of our time. But fingers crossed when the upcoming Cruise film, we get her back on track with our beloved characters making a triumphant return. Anyway, the reason we went them back is to have a big crossover event like Avengers Infinity War and the Dirty Dozen, and for our heroes to take down a big threat. It's real, it's legit, and it's confirmed. There are as many pinpoints that they are existing in the same verse. Make it happen and make it big. If you do, I'll see it 45 times and sell my sword to the handsome man on the moon at the start of the films. And I will buy all the Blu-rays and sell my car and my dog and not eat for a week. Number 3. Gromit and the Feather from Jupiter Ascending lost their voice in a screeching competition. The iconic duo Wallace and Gromit have made one thing clear, that our local second main character Gromit has a non-speaking role in all of his versions of his iconic appearance throughout the history of Wallace and Gromit lore. Gromit is so competitive that he definitely must have had one at some point. I see, before he met Wallace, he went around and screamed as loud as he could and got loads of money and bought equipment for contraptions that made himself and his new friend at the time Wallace get. Wallace was probably in the supermarket buying cheese and helped Gromit with his trolley, maybe so. And for the other guy, I say he was just in the competition with Gromit and screamed very loud, resulting in this.
I think you might have to turn it up.
Number 4. Bellatrix is still alive. Bellatrix is a great, cool, unique and inspiring, and of course hot as hell. But the most important thing to note is that she is extremely powerful. She dies at the hands of Molly Weasley for messing around like a goon to her daughter Ginny. But see how Bellatrix dies? I think when she froze, her soul evaporated everywhere and went somewhere else, and she went flying around the globe. I say she went flying around and ended up in none other than her very own actress, Helena Bonham Carter. Helena was probably in the kitchen doing some dishes when suddenly a big boom, a big smoky beam came through the window. It's the only logical explanation. Bellatrix lives on forever. It's canon, legit, and confirmed. If Kanye West can have fans, why can Bellatrix not still be alive? It's only common sense. Number 5. Oogwee is a twat. Ever noticed that the dragon scroll had nothing on it when Pooh opened it? But if you get the 4K Ultra HD Edition Blu-ray of the masterpiece Kung Fu Panda, if you look close, you can see a bit of dirt on the side of the sheet. This is because Oogwee got an eraser and got rid of what he saw on the iconic actual heroic power that was the Dragon Warrior. Ever notice then how he walks in up the mountain and gets taken away up in the air by a bunch of pink leaves rolling around, rotating him away from facing the iconic foe, Tai Lung? This is because Oogwee was taking the piss and had a lucky escape and let Shifu and all the other baboons die at the paws of a big beast. He also picked Pooh because he just wanted to make Shifu angry and make everyone miserable and simply have a bit of a laugh. I can never look at the stupid looking turtle the same again. At least the stoner fella from Finding Nemo actually put in the effort to aid our protagonist in the mix. Just on a side note, notice how in the Chronicles of Spiderwick, the fella after dies the exact same way. Are they trying to tell us that we should leave leaves alone? Maybe so, but technically these are fairies, so maybe they went to the same place. Who knows? 6. Be Kind Rewind is a parallel world. Iconic Jack Black film, Be Kind Rewind, is the film where he erases a load of videotapes and has to remake them all with his bud. And so, he'll do it in a very low budget way. It's a nice little fun film and has a lot of heartwarming moments, but one of the films they recreate is none other than the iconic Dan Aykroyd Bill Murray film, Ghostbusters. But one thing that they may leave viewers confused is that Ghostbusters actress appears in the film and is playing someone else who is against copyright law. The actress is named Sigourney Weaver. Well, I have the answer for you, because I am a smart little chimp. The reason it takes place in the same universe as The Last Action Hero. In this universe, Be Kind Rewind, there is no such thing as Sigourney Weaver, so in the version of Ghostbusters, Dame Barrett is still in it, but is portrayed by a different actress. This is something I think more films should explain and get into, because it's fun. Number 7. Cersei Lannister likes cake. Number 8. Sharkboy and Lavagirl is a prequel to Aquaman and Star Wars. Sharkboy and Lavagirl is about dreamy, sleepy, nighty, sleepy, sheepy, sheepy shit. But one thing to realise is the whole thing to do with Aquaman and Star Wars. It's a dreamlike world, and Sharkboy and Lavagirl turn it into reality somehow. Lavagirl must be living on Mustafar, and when she got hungry to go eat something and go for coffee, the whole place started erupting with local goons and resulted in the iconic and Anakin and Obi-Wan duel. I say when she got back, she saw Vader screaming at her like Shrek did to get out of his swamp.
This is my fucking spot, get the fuck off!
And for Sharkboy, I think he was probably in the audience having a Califanta orange, watching all the fights go down with Lurkin, Jason Momoa, Aquaman, and the other fella. It doesn't really add much, but I believe it's canon. So should you. Lumberline, I know who the old woman was at the end of Rise of Skywalker. At the end of the iconic end of the new trilogy of Disney films, Rey looks out and sees an old woman staring at her. And I know who it was. Brace yourselves, because your mind is about to be blown. I know it's legit, canon, and confirmed in my own head, because it makes logical sense. So, what she is, it is none other than Emilia Clarke's character, Kira from Solo. And you might be thinking, how did Kira from Solo end up here on the Tatooine? Well, at the end of Solo, A Star Wars Story, she was talking to none other than Darth Maul, and Darth Maul ended up on Tatooine in a fight with Obi-Wan Kenobi. So what happened was, she got stranded there on her own, leaving a horrible, miserable life going around. You might be thinking she was alone, but I think she had the camel, and it was a bit like a war horse, and she looked after the camel, and I think the camel was called Hank, and Hank and her went on so many adventures together, and they had a good time. So she asks Rey who she is, just in case she's dangerous, because she sees a lightsaber that she hasn't seen in years. Anyway, sign me up, Disney. Give me a cake. I got the answer before anyone else. Number 10. I know who Luke's wife was. It was none other than... it was no one. She was just some hot woman he met down the road one day. She works in the tire shop and fixes wagons and puts gas in things. She was just really cool and caught Luke's eye one day. Unfortunately, she was killed by Supreme Leader Snoke, because she laughed like a chimpanzee. Thanks so much, guys, for checking out this video. Be sure to share, subscribe, share again, and donate, if you can, to my Patreon account. I saw that none of you twats last time donated, so I'll try and up the stakes. If you donate more than 60 grand, you get your very own broken chair. Particularly this broken chair was one that got thrown at me by mother director Darren Aaron Offkey after I told him that Jesus wasn't real. Some people take things way too seriously. Ciao for now.
Gills and fins. His teeth became sharp, and we became friends.
Oh, really? Says who?